LFF neatkarības kausa izcīņa ir noslēgusies ar Tottenham Hotspur komandas uzvaru un ar mums kopā ar uzvarētāju komandas galvenais treners. The LFF Independence Cup has finished with the Tottenham Hotspur team victory. Congratulations, coach, and together with us we are speaking today with Mr. Mehmet Ali. You are the head coach for under-16 youth academy in Tottenham Hotspur, so maybe the first question is how much does this victory mean for you in personal, for your guys, and all the process which you are doing in Tottenham for raising and growing the young players?
Firstly, it's a fantastic achievement from the players. We have a young squad here. We have six 2004 players and the rest are 2003s. So it means a lot personally to the staff and to the players to win. We're really proud of them for their achievements. In terms of their long-term development, yes, it's good to win, but now they need to look forward and think about what's going to happen next in their careers. Earning a scholarship, fighting to stay at Tottenham for longer, to try and progress and move through the ranks.
Well, today's final against the German club Hertha BSC, does it bring any extra, you know, intention for the match if you play against German side?
Not really. I think any finals, there's always going to be emotion involved in it. It doesn't matter who we're playing against, we always go into every game wanting to win and play well and play the football that I know that these boys can play, which I think they did. I think both teams look tired before the game. This is a tough tournament. 60-minute matches over 3 days, 5 games. It's a lot of football in the heat on big pitches. So I think both teams look tired. I just think our players found another level today just to try and push on and get over the line, which I was really proud of them for.
Your boys are very happy now in the dressing room. You know, I heard that you've given extra time to celebrate. You know, how does it mean for them personally?
Yeah, of course, the last tournament that these boys won was when they were under 13, so they haven't won a tournament for a long time. Winning is part of their development and improving as a player, and we try and push that and encourage that. But at this stage of their careers, we try and encourage them to try and win in a certain way, in a certain style, a Tottenham way, and I think that they've shown that in this tournament.
Overall, if we evaluate the tournament, you know, this was the first edition of LFF Independence Cup. For us here in Latvia, this is a part of the process of development of the young players when they're coming towards the, you know, next year there will be the national team under 17 already. How do you evaluate the idea in general, you know, how important it is to have these kind of games from all team perspective, you know, to have a chance to play against each other, and how much does this tournament, these games bring for the coaching staff, for the players as well?
I think it's very forward thinking from the Latvian Federation in terms of trying to play against different teams, different styles, different cultures, and coming and playing in this tournament. So I think it's a good idea, it's a good experience for us, because again, the Ukrainian side we played very deep, very difficult to break down. The Czech Republic side, very different. They were very aggressive and put pressure on us high up the pitch. So we had loads of different experiences throughout the tournament, which again is so important for these boys' development as they grow older and as they mature, because they need to face different experiences. They need to play against different styles and different ways and just try and make sure that their style comes out on top, which in this tournament it did.
You know, I cannot ask you a question about the Latvian teams. You know, you played against both of our squads, Team A and Team B, you know, and basically yesterday the win in the penalties shootout, you know. How do you evaluate maybe the strength of our players? And as a coach, maybe you see some things where they need to improve, you know, to get to the top level maybe in the future. How do you evaluate Latvian players, which you're seeing here today?
I think that's a difficult question, because obviously the two teams we played, I thought they were very similar, very different Latvia B team to Latvia A team, in terms of when we played the Latvia B team, they only needed a draw to qualify for the group. So in that game, they allowed us to have the ball, they played 4-4-2, they played a little bit deeper, and they tried to catch us on the counter-attack. They wasted a lot of time with throw-in set pieces, because understandably, they only needed a draw to get through to the latter stages of the tournament. Latvia A was a different game. You know, our players looked very small compared to their boys. They were big, they were strong, and they were very aggressive from the first minute. They were a very aggressive side, the Latvian A team that we played, in terms of tackles, challenges, and they tried to intimidate us with that. So very different games and different styles. But my experience as a coach and my advice would be, whatever style or way you want to play to win football games, you need to make sure you implement that to the best of your ability to try and progress and develop your players, and that was the way that the Latvian sides wanted to play, which is respect to them, and it's down to them to make sure that that's the best possible system.
And last two questions. First, if you will receive the invitation for the next year's edition of the Independence Cup, are you coming here as well? And secondly, did you have any congratulation messages, WhatsApp calls, or just simply calls from the first Tottenham team squad?
Firstly, we would love to come and hold on to what we've won already with a different age group. So obviously, like I said, we have some 2004 players that have played in this one. They'll be eligible to play again next year. So we'd love to come and try and make it 2 out of 2. And lastly, no, the first team are very busy and we haven't had anything at the moment. But we have had a lot of messages from the academy department saying congratulations. And I believe they all watched it back in the UK at 8 a.m. and we've got a lot of messages.
So we know also that our colleagues from communication department in Tottenham Hotspur are busy very at the moment, just making sure that this achievement is very widely recognized. Thank you very much for coming here. It was a pleasure to watch you, first of all, and one more time, congratulations on the victory, and looking forward to see you once again here in Latvia.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
very
much, coach.
Thank you.
All the best.
Thank you.